The topic in this video is the cable suspension system for our KPL and KWM pumps. Agenda. Purpose of the cable suspension system, how it is designed, how to install it, and how to use it as lifting equipment. The purpose of the cable suspension system is to stabilize the cables in the column tube and thereby avoiding the cables from being damaged by moving from side to side in the water flow. The standard cable suspension system is a wire rope design consisting of two turnbuckles, three shackles, one wire holder, one or more cable clamps, and a wire rope. For installations in deep column pipes, one or more master links can be added. The cable suspension system is application specific as it depends on the diameter of the column tube, the height from the top of the column tube and down to the lifting bracket on the pump, the number and the diameter of the power cables. Therefore, the cable suspension system is made to order and cannot be put on stock. The standard cable suspension system is made in stainless steel 304 EN1 4301. Other materials might be available on request. The cable clamps are designed with rounded edges to prevent damaging the cables. The holes in the cable clamps for the cables are slightly smaller than the diameter of the cables to secure a firm grip and fixed position on the cables. The holes in the cable clamps for the wire rope is slightly bigger in diameter than the diameter of the wire rope. In this way, the wire rope can be tightened up in the column tube without risking to apply stress to the cables or even to pull out the cables from the cable inlets. Position the pumps in horizontal position with the cables in a parallel line away from the motor top. Support the cables so they will be in the same level as from the motor top, for instance using a pallet. Mount the wire rope onto the lifting bracket and place it on a line with the cables in a way that makes it easy to install the cable clamps onto the cables and the wire rope. Install the first cable clamp nearby the motor top without tightening the bolts. The distance between the cable clamp and the wire rope must not exceed 300 mm. Position the following cable clamps with a distance of around 500 mm. The last cable clamp can be installed around 500 mm from the upper wire clamp. Tightening all the clamps around the power cables. Before tightening the clamps around the sensor cable, make sure the length of the sensor cable between the motor top and the first clamp is around 20 to 30 mm longer than the corresponding length of the power cable. This is important to avoid stress in the course of the sensor cable. When lowering down the pump into the column tube, it is important to take good care of the cables. In this way, we can avoid damaging the rubber surface of the cables. With the pump in place on the seat ring, it is time to tighten up the wire rope using the turnbuckles. Remember, when tightening the turnbuckles, we are only tightening the wire rope, not the cables. When the wire rope has the right tension, without lifting the pump from the seat ring, it is time to pull the cables by hand. It is important not to pull in the sensor cable, but only in the power cable, and be sure not to pull the cables out of the cable inlets. Tightening the rubber bushing in the cable inlet in the column tube. To make a better and faster installation of the cables in the column tube, it is advisable to use a cable inlet design that will give access to the cables when the lid of the column tube is taken off. It is the rubber bushing that holds the cables up in the column tube, and it is the wire rope that prevents the cable from moving from side to side. The standard cable suspension system is not approved as lifting equipment. If it is needed to use it for lifting the pump and the cables, the wire rope, the shackles, and if installed, the master links needs to be purchased local with the right certificates and rated for the weight of the pump and the cables. If those components are approved as lifting equipment, they can be used for lifting the pump. Be aware that the wire holder is not approved as lifting equipment, and therefore shackle number 1 is not allowed to hook onto. Use instead shackle number 2 or the upper lifting eye in the wire rope.